first for Minnesota. Chalmers is out there with Teagle.
And there's money. And it's Bargnani in at the four spot.
And for Denver, then there's Harrison Barnes. And it's Grant in at the power forward position. Tip-off goes to Denver. Pass to James. James gets the screen from Simmons. That's good from Barnes on the assist by James. Barnes has got the opening basket of the game for Denver. James against Chalmers. Berry passes to Chalmers. Here's Money. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Just five to shoot. From 13, Barnes grabs the miss. Barnes gets a screen from Simmons. Up off the
ground. Well, that's a solidly executed pick play. I mean, it paid dividends with that nice dunk.
Exactly the result they were looking for.
Yeah, it worked so well. I mean, he got set, did not shuffle his feet. Really well done there offensively.
The drive by James, and Denver again with the bucket. On defense, Denver. All right, let's go over to the sideline with Doris Burke.
I briefly spoke with the home team's head coach. I asked him about the matchup problems created by a player like Andrea Bargnani, a 7-foot sharpshooter. He said he can give us problems, no doubt. It's tough to really bother that shot, and he can also put it on the deck and drive. We've got to just get into his body, try to make him a facilitator rather than a scorer. Kevin, we'll see if they're successful.
And thank you, Doris. Now here's James. First quarter, about a minute and a half in. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot two.
Great job. Take it right at the defense. I like the aggressiveness.
Yeah, he left them no choice but to foul there.
Denver shooting their first free throw. First trip to the line in this one. And he knocks down the first one. So he makes one of two as the second one misses. Here's Minnesota. 6-point game. Teagle the pass to Berry. He passes to Teagle. Watch outside. Passes to Chalmers. They get the rebound. And goaltending is going to be the call. So they get the basket there anyway.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
And that call gets an instant reaction from the fans.
Well, that's a whistle that did not go over very well.
James dishes to Simmons. Fires high post. Rebounded by Berry.
Well, they're shooting 75% here early on, even with that miss.
Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Chalmers against James. And he hits it just before the shot clock expires. Chalmers has got his first points in this one. Here's Red Hot. Here's James. And he hits the jump shot.
4 or 5 shots have dropped for them already. Not a bad way to get things started.
Teagle the pass to Bargnani. That's tipped. And here we go. Barnes kicks to Grant. The pass to Blackman.
And of all the things about him that you like offensively, it's his composure that jumps out at me. The way he never gets rattled. The defense can get in him. He doesn't care. He just continues to do his thing.
You know, something else with him, you can't forget about his skill as a pull-up shooter. I mean, you give him too much room, and he won't hesitate for a second to raise up and spray you with that J.
All free throws good from Blackman. Minnesota trails by 6. And here is Chalmers. And stolen by Barnes.
That's two unproductive trips in a row, ending in turnover.
And one thing you can't do is string together those kinds of possessions. It'll really snowball on you.
First quarter of action, just under 3.5 minutes played. Grant. Pass to Blackman. Back to Grant. Clock at 6. And that one's good.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Minnesota trails by 8. Chalmers with it. Now guarded by Blackman. Here's Perry. And that comes off the assist by Mario Chalmers. And so here's Denver. Pass to Barnes. Some solid defense there from Bargnani.
You know, typically, guys, he has the body control to finish when he's in that tight. I'm not sure what happened there.
Passes it to Teagle. Plenty of space. It's rebounded by Blackman.
Boy, that's a warm-up jumper there. I mean, when you're a pro, you can't make excuses for missing that one.
Kicks it to Grant. Second chance shot. A stupendous finish in traffic. Grant's got 5 points so far.
They've worked hard and created great chances for themselves in this opening quarter.
Well, if they can match that effort at the defensive end, look out.
And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. He feeds it to Bargnani. To the middle. Teagle.
Well, they find themselves with a big deficit here in the first. One category that jumps out at me, second chance point. Only one bucket for him.
James dishes to Barnes. That drops. 6 points for him.
He's having quite the quarter here, guys. I mean, shooting the ball extremely well.
Timeout call, first of the game for Minnesota. Buck, what do you think they need to do to get back in the game?
Well, Kevin, one thing, they've got plenty of time, that's for sure. And I think establishing their inside presence, picking up the intensity and the effort, creating more hustle opportunities, and then rebounding the basketball. Mm-hmm. That's a lot, but they've got a lot of work to do.
Sounds like a good recipe. Minnesota trails by 10. Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Chalmers pass to Berry. Back to Chalmers. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. He dishes it to Bargnani. 5 to shoot. Shoots. And he makes good on his first shot of the game.
Very well done. He is a confident, dynamic scorer.
And there's the pass to Blackman. Fires from deep. Can't get it to go. And Minnesota now the other way. Here's Teagle. Berry passes to Bargnani. Money defended by Blackman. They're whistled for a blocking foul, and he'll head to the line. And what's your take, guys, in the hustle stats for Denver?
Well, I think the defensive aggressiveness on display here has caught him off guard, playing airtight defense and coming up with the steals.
And the other thing they're doing is forcing a lot of turnovers, and that's helping them to get easy points at the other end.
The first free throw is good. Davis is checked in for Denver. And he can't hit the second. Denver leading by 7. Feeds it to James. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. James has got 6.
4 of their last 5 makes came off of a high-quality shot inside.
Yeah, that's textbook basketball. Just having their way down low.
Here's Teagle, and the call will be against Redhawks. That is his first foul of the game. Smith checked in for money. James against Chalmers. Off the left rim and out.
And the defense got away with a major lapse there.
Here's James. Shot is off. Great D that time from Chalmers. Minnesota trails by 9. Here's Smith. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over. Smith's got his first bucket in this one.
Boy, he crashed the boards with purpose right there. Well-deserved second chance points for him.
James with it, now defended by Mario Chalmers. Number 30. Here's Chalmers. Dishes it to Bargnani. Back to Chalmers. Lots of room. Drain for 2 points. Denver leading by 7. James outside. No one near him. Denver the rebound. Blackman the pass to Davis. And Chalmers kicks to Smith. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
For Minnesota, they have gone 2 of 4 at the free throw line. And the first one at the line is good. Minnesota making a switch here. Smith hits them both. And so here's Denver, leading by 5. Doubled by Hawes. Hit his leg. And the ref saying he kicked it. Number 6. They grab their own miss. A second chance effort. Number 30. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2.
Yeah, the defender draped all over him.
Pretty plain and simple. Got him good there.
This is his first free throw of the game. First free throw is good. That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
Well, you kind of expect that from him. You pretty much know what the result's going to be when he goes to the line.
Smith outside. Williams has a screen for Smith. The feed to Williams. And it's Denver with the rebound. Davis has got his 3rd rebound tonight.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
Yeah, it's a physical game, and so far the numbers show that they've got the edge on the glass.
Denver with the ball. It's a 5-point game. Number 6. Rebound Minnesota.
Yeah, no excuses there. Got a really good look at the basket after being freed up by the pick.
We say it all the time. The execution was excellent. The result not as good, but good ball movement anyway.
Here is House. 6 on the shot clock. Back to Johnson. Fader on the way. Minnesota shooting their 7th and 8th free throw attempts for the game right here. Well, free throw drops for Hawes. And he makes both free throws.
Well, as far as the league's big men go, he's one of the very best at the foul line.
Denver passing it around. The dish to Davis. Number 30, headed by Hawes. Number 30, rebound by Smith.
And poor shooting from him this quarter. His shooting percentage nowhere near where he'd like it to be.
Hawes kicks to Johnson. Again, Johnson missing.
We got a narrow edge here in rebounding early on. You wonder how much that'll play going forward.
Well, I like the way they've set the tone. You know, they're going to have to continue to work at it, but rebounds will be key in this game, no question about it.
And he should thank the defense for those 2 points, really. Nobody paid him any mind there.
He kicks it to Smith. House, he's guarded by Williams. Back to Smith. Minnesota needs to get off a shot here. Williams dishes to Davis, number 30. And that one falls, coming off of Davis's feed. He's got 6. Minnesota trails by 7. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, I mean, a cold stretch offensively. They desperately need a basket.
Minnesota calls timeout. Johnson kicks to House. With the lead pass, Hawes, no luck. Denver leading by 7. 43 seconds left to play here in the first. The kick out to Williams.
Oh, yeah, he had not established position.
You know, I prefer the refs to whistle at a block when in doubt. I thought that was a good call there.
Second foul of the first quarter. They're probably going to have to sit him down here to try to avoid number 3.
For Denver, they have hit most of their free throws tonight, 5 of 6. He misses the free throw. And the second free throw, good.
They find themselves down here in the first, and a lot of that can be attributed to the early foul trouble.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Johnson goes in. Smith outside. Outside Williams. Back to Smith. 5 on the clock. He passes to Johnson. Out of bounds. Denver takes possession. Seven seconds left in the first quarter. And Williams, here we go.
Nice job again that time to add to their lead. I'll tell you what, they're doing everything right at this moment.
They're playing steadily in all aspects of the game, Steve. You're exactly.
Welcome back, everyone. A lopsided first quarter in the books already as we start this second quarter. And when you consider how Denver is doing, Steve and Clark, what are your thoughts?
Man, I thought the defense was key here for this club. They really tightened up and made it difficult on their opponent.
How about the help on the drives and rotations? I mean, they've really been in sync as a unit.
Now let's go to Doris Burke. Doris.
Well, guys, Andrea Bargnani, the number 1 overall pick back in 2006, but he hasn't been a star caliber player in the NBA. Injuries have played a role, certainly, but his defense and rebounding have been the biggest problems. A former coach of his with the Raptors said it just didn't seem like he had enough passion for the game, that it wasn't important enough to him. Some pretty harsh words, but guys, sometimes for 7-footers, the game finds them. And defense and rebounding, certainly not the glamorous parts of this game. Kevin, we'll see if he ever realizes his potential.
And hope for the best. Thanks, Doris. And it's blocked by Hawes. And now Minnesota on the fast break. Here is House. Johnson, the pass to House. Shot clock at 6. And the shot is good. House has got his 2nd basket of the game. Outside Williams. To the paint, number 6. And that one falls, coming off of Davis's feed. Davis has got 3 assists in the game. Johnson outside. Johnson off the pick from Harris. Johnson kicks to Williams. Pass to Smith. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. Minnesota making some changes. Money's checked in for Williams. And it's Teagland for Eddie House. Teagle drops one in from the wing.
Perfect inbounds pass and an easy 2 points.
Denver leading by eight. Pass to Barnes. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. Six to shoot. It's stolen by Johnson. Teagle. The fast break ends at the rim with a jam.
Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
Here's Davis. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
And no question, he got bumped on that shot.
Definitely no room for discussion on that one.
For Denver, they have scored 6 points from their 8 attempts at the line so far. Minnesota making a switch here. Bargnani's checked in. Johnson outside. Pass to Bargnani. Tries from the block. And again, it's Minnesota converting.
And they're making this a game here, putting together a nice run.
Making it a game? How about anybody's game? I mean, they've caught fire, and it's a toss-up right now, guys.
Williams passes to Blackman. Back to Williams. Kicks to Barnes. Whoops, anticipated the pass. Turnover. He feeds it to Bargnani. And again, it's Minnesota converting. And now we'll get a perspective here on the hustle game. How it's been going for Minnesota.
Boy, their frenetic defense has really been impressive, putting a lot of pressure on ball handlers and turning them over.
And I really think you've got to love the way they protected the rim today. I mean, a good number of blocks in the first half.
Shot's good.
And that assist earned him a little nod from his teammate after the basket.
Here's Teagle. Smith outside. Johnson. It's good, the assist that time from Smith. Johnson's got four this quarter.
Now they've done a great job of getting into the middle of that defense and scoring in the paint.
Well, and that's why they're on this run, guys. They're getting the ball inside and getting really high percentage looks.
Barnes kicks to Williams. Lock at six. Denver needs to get off a shot, and Davis backs down. Bargnani grabs the board. Bargnani's got his third rebound on the night. Johnson kicks to Smith. There's the pass to Teagle. Back to Smith. Here's Teagle. Johnson outside. A baseline J. Goes back up. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. For Minnesota, they have scored 6 points from their 8 attempts at the line so far. Free throw good, Bargnani. Minnesota making a switch here. And it's tied up with that one. And so here's Denver. They've held a 12-point lead earlier. He dishes it to Barnes. And that's a foul called on Money. That's his third foul of the game.
Already he's looking at his third foul. I think the coach will probably look to sit him down until the third quarter.
Barnes kicks to Grant. Denver the rebound. Out of bounds, Minnesota takes possession.
Way too loose on that inbounds pass.
So it's Minnesota now. Only given up 6 here in this quarter. Number 24. And that comes off the assist by Mario Chalmers.
You know, he didn't need to make the layup complicated. I mean, it's not a trick shot contest. But he decided to go for a little extra flavor on that one.
Feeds to Grant. And he was camped in the lane there, and he gets the 3-second call. Minnesota with the ball. They're on an 18-4 run right now. Pass to Berry. Here's Teagle. Dishes it to Chalmers. Poke loose. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. James checked in for Williams.
Mike James.
Denver on D. Trailing by two. Shot clock at six. Bargnani dishes to Chalmers. Nailed from three-point land. Chalmers has got seven.
Boy, what a significant turnaround here in the second quarter after only making 40% from the field in the first.
And Denver decides to take their first time out here.
Well, I felt like his defense was letting him down out there, guys, so he wanted to get a timeout to talk it over and try to tighten things up here.
You know, part of coaching, a lot of coaching actually, is making sure that momentum never gets too far away from your team. That's a good timeout.
Grant the pass to Blackman. And there's the feed to James. Will not go. This is off the front iron. Minnesota leading by five. Back to Chalmers. Passes it to Teagle. The dish to Bargnani. Just five on the clock. Teagle. And it's Denver with the rebound. James has got his third rebound tonight. Barnes, and down it goes, jamming that one home.
Now that is a quick bucket, pretty good in transition.
That's right, that's exactly right. He loves when he gets the chance to get out and run. That's when he's at his best.
Now the pass to Teagle. He kicks it to Bargnani. No coverage that time. Bargnani's got eight here in the quarter.
And he's shaking off a poor first quarter shooting effort. He's really starting to turn it on now, guys.
Minnesota with the ball. Pass to Teagle. Back to Chalmers. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. The offensive rebound. Count that one.
And guys, they continue to put a lot of pressure on the interior defenders with the way they work down low.
Well, it's become one of the stories of the first half, Mark. Just piling up points in the paint.
Here's James. He passes to Simmons. And he finishes nicely on the layup.
Good job threading that pass into the lane. I like his vision, guys. He sees everything.
Here's Teagle. Passes it to Berry. On the left block, Barnes grabs the miss. Denver trails by five. The drive by James. Pass to Barnes. Kicks it to Simmons. Fires the three. Bargnani grabs the board. Bargnani's got his fifth rebound in this one. The pass to Berry. Here's Teagle. He feeds it to Bargnani. Good on the three-point shot. Bargnani's got 14.
Wow, he's got such a sweet three-point stroke. The way he can shoot it, forcing opposing bigs out on the perimeter, can really open up the lane.
There's Red Hot. He dishes it to Simmons. Gets the bucket.
He didn't get off to much of a start early on, but he seems to have shaken off the rust here in the quarter.
Now Chalmers. He's got seven. Here's Berry. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
This is what this team is all about here. I mean, they're forcing their way inside, just bulldozing themselves into the paint area, and they're having a lot of success.
Blackman, the pass to Barnes. There's Red Hot, defended by Berry. Six on the shot clock. James outside. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Williams, he's checked in for Minnesota. Smith comes in for Teagle. Minnesota leading by eight. Now, here's Chalmers. Down to five on the shot clock. Number 24. And it's good with time running down on the shot clock. He has six.
He's done a nice job, a great job, actually, of finding efficient shots here in the second. Shooting percentage always a function of the kinds of shots you get. And he's on a good roll after struggling a bit in the first.
Their free throw attempts have really fallen off here in the second quarter. Not as aggressive.
Yeah, if they want to avoid going into the half with this deficit, they need to stop settling for these long jump shots and attack the rim.
For Denver, they have shot 60% from the line, 6 of 10.
You know, in the first, I thought he did a really good job of putting pressure on the defense and creating opportunities at the foul line for himself. Not as much here in the second.
Minnesota in the lead. Feeds to Smith. Back to Chalmers. Dishes it to Bargnani. And a miss there on the triple. Here's Denver now. Screened by Grant. Number 30. And he comes off the screen to bury the jump shot. 10 points for him.
You know, he's knocking down his shots today, but it hasn't really translated to the scoreboard yet.
Bargnani sets the screen for Smith. That's good.
Three consecutive baskets have come right at the rim. The defense had better start buckling down and tightening up.
Yeah, they're getting exposed right now.
The feed to Grant. Pass to Blackman. Back to Grant. James to the inside. Here's Simmons. Banked in off the glass. Simmons got 7 points for the quarter.
And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today. A
lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
1 second separate in the shot clock and game clock. And Chalmers kicks to Smith. Fires it up. They get it back. Number 24. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face. 8 points for him. Here's James. No good on the buzzer beater. So we've reached the end of the first half of play. Minnesota leads by 9. And join us right back here after the break for the start of the second half.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
And coming your way now, the Monday edition of our halftime show. Let's get it started. Some good basketball for Minnesota. They've done a great job executing their offense. They've been avoiding sloppy mistakes. Andrea Bargnani not having any problems out there. He's got 14 points and also has grabbed 5 boards. And on the other hand, a major undertaking to stay alive for Denver. They've been putting a lot of defensive pressure on the other team, taking care of the rock offensively, fundamental basketball, both sides of the court. Harrison Barnes getting it done through 2 quarters. He's got 8 points and is putting out the effort defensively as well, making his presence felt on both ends of the floor. That'll wrap things up for me here in the studio. Thanks so much. I'm Damon Bruce. Now let's get back out to Kevin Harlan for the second half of play.
The Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
Now the second half about to start up and begin any moment. We're seeing a tremendous game from Bargnani.
He is a dynamic scorer, guys. That much we know. And I'll tell you what, his talent was on full display there in the first half.
Steve, he is a hard man to keep down. And so far, they've been unable to do it.
Obvious foul.
Yeah, he took a hit right there and earned those free throws.
He's gone 3 for 4 from the line. First one falls for him. And Bargnani drops them both. Denver trails by 11. James kicks to Barnes. Back to James. The fadeaway. Here's Simmons. And count the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
You got to put bodies on the glass right there. They just are not getting it done on the boards.
Yeah, they've got to do a much better job of going harder than that to the glass.
The free throw off from Simmons. Minnesota leading by 9. Teagle the pass to Berry. And he goes. goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
How about that? Breaking out the Statue of Liberty on that dunk.
A nice way to pad that lead a little more.
Yeah, you got that right.
The drive by James. And Simmons kicks to James. Denver passing it around. Out of bounds. Minnesota takes possession. 8 seconds. Here's Minnesota.
Come on, box it out, man.
Second half rolling along now. About a minute played here. Passes it to Teagle. Back to Chalmers. Six to shoot. High post try. Rebounded by Blackman. Denver trails by 11. James kicks to Barnes. Here's Simmons. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Three trips to the line so far for him in this one.
Simmons at the line for two.
The first one falls. Both free throws good from Simmons. And we're just about a minute and a half into the third quarter of basketball. Chalmers with it. He has seven. Number 24. Denver grabs the miss. Barnes has got his fourth rebound in this one. The dish to James. He kicks to Barnes. Sinks the three-pointer. Barnes has got 11 points.
D there, guys, was pretty much non-existent. I mean, you can't leave a good shooter like that open.
And here is Chalmers. Teagle the pass to Bargnani. The good-looking shot from the wing. He's got 18. Denver trails by 8. James outside. And here's Barnes for 3. Denver the rebound.
Multiple possessions have been the story of the game. And even with the big lead, this team continues to be quicker to the ball.
Ben Sanity has checked in for Denver. Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. James kicks to Grant. Shot clock at 6. Red hot. Trying his luck deep. Rebound by Mario Chalmers. Minnesota leading by 8. The pass to Teagle. Shot on the wing, and that one's good. He's got 6.
He had a whole lot of space to get that shot off.
Yeah, I don't think the defender did a good job there of getting over the top of the screen.
Denver calls timeout.
You know, he just isn't pleased at all with the looks they've given up defensively inside. So I think this timeout is all about trying to get his group to tighten up defensively.
They just don't look very sharp to me on the defensive side.
Pass to Blackman. James left side. Wide open look. And another miss by Denver.
More often than not today, those shots have not dropped for him.
Passes to Barry. Here's Teagle. Gives him the lead pass. Number 24. Great pass to set up the lay-in. And it's a 12-point Minnesota lead. And here is James. He has 6. He passes it to Grant. Back to James. They get it again. Here's Gatling. Blocked. And the pass to Teagle. And that comes off the assist by Mario Chalmers. Chalmers has got 4 assists in the game. And guys, what do you think about the hustle stats here for Minnesota?
Their defense has been outstanding, Kevin, closing out on shots, blocking a lot of them as well.
The number of second chance points they've gotten is also impressive. I mean, they've kept so many possessions alive with offensive rebounds.
Minnesota calls timeout. And during the timeout, both coaches getting a chance here to review the strategy at this point of the game, along with the discussions. Also, some rehydration going on with Gatorade. Everyone trying to bring their game here tonight.
Yeah, that's why you see the trainers going around to every player, making sure they're hydrated, they're getting enough to drink during the game. And so important to hydrate yourself and keep yourself strong and ready to play for these big minutes down the stretch.
Spencer Hawes has checked in for Minnesota. House comes in for Teagle. So it's Minnesota now. Bargnani dishes to Chalmers. Pass to Berry. And the layup is good. Money's got 11.
He has great dexterity inside. He can contort his body, shift in midair, hang time. He can protect the ball and finish through contact. Just an impressive player in the paint.
And Steve, that's not a skill that most players have. I mean, that's exactly why they try to feed it to him in the paint whenever possible.
Minnesota leading by 12. Here is Chalmers. He has 7. Chalmers off the pick from Hawes. Pass to Bargnani. Kicks to House. No good on the triple.
Kind of rare to see him come up empty on a wide open look.
Barnes passes to James. Grant outside. Pass to Insanity. Denver passing it around. Barnes. And he wheels that one in. Sinking right through off the back iron. Now Chalmers. He feeds it to House. He dishes it to Bargnani. And there's the pass to Berry.
How about that game for Money? He's got 11 points, and he's added a steal to his stat line also.
Well, that's obviously not a big number, but you know, he's been doing some valuable defensive work for them.
He's shooting free throws, number 4 in 5 here. That's good from Berry. Denver making a switch here. That misses, so he splits the free throws. Denver trails by 11. Blackman, the pass to Simmons. Stolen by Bargnani. It's 2-on-1. Ahead. Pass to Berry. Feeds it to Chalmers. Passes it to Berry. Out of bounds. Denver takes possession. Minnesota making a switch here. This gives them the opportunity to get within 10. Number 6. And the lead is down inside single digits. He has 5. Minnesota leading by 9. Here's Teagle. He's got 8. Unloads. Kept alive. Number 24. And the defense didn't have position. They whistle a blocking foul, and he'll go to the line. First trip to the free throw line for him in this one. And the first one drops. He hits both from the stripe.
Kevin, right now, they're doing a good job at the line. They're hovering around 83, 84, 85% from the stripe. That's good stuff. I mean, that's well done.
Offensive rebound, Simmons. And there's the bucket. Stay with it on the offensive glass, getting it done.
That's exactly what they had in mind on that possession.
And Chalmers kicks to House. Number 24. He's covered by Grant. Number 24. Another miss by Minnesota.
He's one guy the defense is not afraid to leave open from that range, and for obvious reasons.
James in the post. Defended by Chalmers. Back to James. For the three. Count the bucket. James has got nine.
Boy, I tell you what, he loves getting looks like that from the three-point line. No one near him. That's a warm-up jumper for him.
Dishes to House. This one for three. It's rebounded by Blackman. Red Ox got his third rebound on the night. Took him no time at all on that one. And now it's just a four-point Minnesota lead.
Things are really tightening up now, guys. Their offense has become unstoppable.
Not sure where it was before, but better late than never.
The feed to House. Three-pointer. Gets it to go. He has seven.
Talk about doing a Rip Van Winkle on defense. Come on, guys, wake up. Why are they leaving him open at the three-point line? Come on.
Back to James. The pass to Blackman. Four on the shot clock. Knocked away. And now Chalmers running the floor all by himself. That's good. And it's a nine-point Minnesota lead.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
Denver calls timeout.
They've been very untidy with the ball here. You commit turnovers when you try to do too much or you force it. They need to focus on making the simple play, good passes, and moving the ball around.
Minnesota making some changes. Bargnani comes in for Spencer Hawes. And it's Johnson in for Mario Chalmers. Here's Grant. Minnesota with the rebound. They've led by as many as 14 points. House kicks to Johnson. Shoots from eight. Number 24. And so it's Minnesota with it. They have a nine-point lead from 11 feet away. Great D that time from Barnes. He kicks it to Grant. Number six, defended by House. The dish now to Davis. Grant outside. Lock at six. Number six. Offensive rebound. Changes up. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. And this is his second trip to the line tonight. And he makes the first. Some changes for Minnesota. Money's checked in for Teagle. And it's Chalmers in for Eddie House.
The story in the first half was their low free throw percentage. They've corrected that here in the second half, and hopefully they can build on it as this game continues to progress.
Johnson kicks to Bargnani. There's the triple. Can't get it to go. And it's Denver the other way. Back to Grant. Denver passing it around. Davis with a screen on Johnson. Pass to James. Davis. Defended by Chalmers. And Davis gets it to go.
Boy, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip. They've got a battle inside.
Well, this game has been tough, Clark. I mean, they're getting after it. And I think they're starting to run a little bit low on energy, possibly.
Down low. Lays it in off a pretty alley-oop. And Minnesota leads by seven.
Boy, you gotta love it. The picture-perfect alley-oop.
A little surprise, though, Clark. He didn't go for the big slam, but it works just the same.
You know what, too?
Yeah, but it almost makes it a little more special, Kev. Just grace over power is the way I see it.
Johnson, the pass to Berry. Backs down. Chalmers dishes to Johnson. Kicks it to Bargnani. Number 24. Pass to Berry. The rebound by Grant. Grant's got four rebounds in this game. About 3 seconds between shot and game clock. Barnes can't get it to go. Minnesota leading by seven. Passes to Berry. He feeds it to Bargnani. Chalmers. They swipe it. Number six. Misses. The third quarter comes to a close. Minnesota on top, leading by 7. Well, welcome back as we get set to start the 4th. Now here's James. He passes to Blackman. Puts it up. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here. The first one falls. Both free throws good from Blackman. Minnesota in the lead. Johnson outside. Puts the lead pass in front of him. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot 2. And the first one drops.
So they've really improved at the line from the first half. Things have gotten a lot better. They've gotten there a good number of times, and they've converted a high percentage of them. Well, this team does not waste opportunities at the foul line. They make the opponents pay when they foul. If they get sent to the line, they're cashing in.
The drive by James. Here's Davis. Bagnani grabs the board. Minnesota leading by 7. Johnson up top, covered by Barnes. Now the pass to Berry. Back to Johnson. The high post shot. Barnes grabs the miss. Barnes has got his 6th rebound on the night. Johnson's gotten only 2 of his 8 attempts to fall from the floor. Shoots from 8. Chalmers with it. He dishes it to Johnson. Pass to Berry. Back to Johnson. 6 to shoot. Feeds it to Bargnani. Dishes to Chalmers. Here's the 3. Denver grabs the miss. Clark, they've been looking out of sync offensively.
You know what? A basket here would do a lot for their confidence.
James kicks to Barnes. Throws it from outside. Barnes has got 10 points here in the second half. And so it's Minnesota with it. 4-point game. Minnesota calls timeout.
And I think he believes that if he takes some time here to kind of talk things over, it'll be well served for this club.
And you know, maybe this gives him an opportunity to toy around with some of their game plan while he has their attention during this break in the action.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Hi, Kevin. The head coach for the visiting team had some instruction for his guys during that last break. With his team struggling from 3-point territory, he told them to start looking for more high-quality shots inside the paint. We're forcing too many threes, he said. Stop with the bombs and work it inside.
And Bargnani backs in, and it's blocked by Grant. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the 4th. Passes it to Blackman. Misses off the right iron. Minnesota leading by 4. And the basket by Teagle.
Well, he's very strong inside, particularly as a finisher. So even if you give him a hard foul, hard contact, nothing seems to bother him. And this guy, as a result, is a good scorer.
Exactly. That's about the only way to stop him once he's making a run at the hoop.
Grant kicks to James. Knocked loose. And here comes House, leading the fast break. And that one's good. And it's an 8-point Minnesota lead.
Boy, they are just destroying them in the paint.
You could say that again, Steve. The defenders just aren't aggressive enough down low.
That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line that time.
Now you wonder why his team's losing. He keeps giving the ball away time after time.
Smith checked in for Minnesota. A pass to Teagle. There's the feed to House. He kicks to Bargnani. There's the dish to House. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. 6 on the shot clock. Another miss by Minnesota.
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, he had a really good look. I mean, he'll knock that down more often than not.
Back to James. Launches a 3. Gets it to go.
little bit of a defensive breakdown there. He's not the guy you want to leave open on the perimeter. You've got to stay attached to him.
House, the pass to Bargnani. Smith kicks it to House. Pass to Teagle. Smith outside. And that one's good. And here is James. Back to Grant. Number 30. And again, it's Denver.
Boy, he made a nice little bounce pass there. We call that the pocket pass, and he did it well.
Here is House. He passes to Teagle. He feeds it to House. Shot clock at 6. Bargnani kicks to House. That 3 off the mark.
Tell you what, the defense has nothing to worry about out there with him shooting. I mean, he can't dial it in from deep this half at all.
Back to Grant. And he draws body contact. Looked like a blocking foul, and he was in the shooting motion. So he'll head to the free throw line. Andre Bargnani picks one up. And the first one at the line is good. Minnesota making a switch here. And Grant drops them both. Minnesota leading by 3. Now Chalmers. Back to Bargnani. Takes the 3. It's rebounded by Simmons. Simmons got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Pass to Grant. And the shot counts. He's fouled, and it's a chance for a 3-point play.
He's one of the best in the league at that. Even with just a tiny sliver, he always seems to find a way to get it up and in.
Here's Teagle. Passes it to Berry. Here's Teagle. He dishes it to Chalmers. Connects from 3-point range.
That's his first 3-pointer of the half. Remember, he did make one in the first half as well.
James gets the screen from Simmons. And it's good. James has got 5 points now this quarter.
Solid screen right there that freed him up for the jump shot.
The pass to Berry. Out of bounds. Denver takes possession.
Boy, just a brain cramp, guys. I mean, that should have been the simplest of exchanges.
Here's Denver now. Now here's James. Blackman, the pass to Grant. Feeds to Barnes. Dishes it to Simmons. Hook shot on the way. And the shot falls short this time. Minnesota in the lead. He kicks to Chalmers. Pass to Teagle. Number 24. Great tee that time from James. He's one assist away from the double-double.
Yeah, we have seen some tremendous passing from him.
Chalmers with it. He passes to Teagle. Another miss by Minnesota. And here is James. Barnes passes to Blackman. That misses off the backboard. Red Hot's gone just 1 of 5 from the field. Number 24, defended by Simmons. Here's Berry. Drains it from 17 feet out. Money's got 9 points here in the second half. Denver trails by 4. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
James outside. 6 on the shot clock. Barnes dishes to James. Off target from 3-point range. Minnesota leading by 4. Teagle the pass to Chalmers. Number 24 defended by Simmons. They get it back. Number 24 shakes off the strong D and gets to the bucket for 2. Here's James. Denver calls timeout. You have to like what we're seeing so far from Bargnani.
They don't seem to have any answers for him. They need to review their game plan and look for a way to cool him off.
keep my feet planted to the earth, cause the people that hurt can understand it.
Cuts off the pass. Chalmers against James. Here's Teagle. Pass to Berry. Covered by Barnes. Shot clock at 5. Shoots. That one a little long.
Well, in the rebounding game at least, it's been a strong physical performance for them.
But it has to translate, Clark, if they're going to cut into this lead. They've got to convert those boards into points.
Looked like he rushed that one, guys. The defense was out of position. He was wide open, just couldn't take advantage.
Number 24, defended by Blackman. Now the feed to Bargnani. There's the dish to Chalmers. Launches it. And another three for Minnesota.
Right now, the defense needs to do a better job of closing out on this guy. He's heating up from outside.
The drive by James to end the drought, and it's good on the way in. James has got 7 points for the quarter. Minnesota leading by 7. Chalmers pass to Teagle. Back to Chalmers. Out of bounds. Denver takes possession.
Such a careless pass. You've got to keep your head in the game here.
Johnson, he's checked in for Teagle. Kicks to James. .153 left in the fourth quarter.
Take a look at the numbers in this one for James.
He's got 16 points,
and what a game he's had passing the ball, too.
Yeah, to watch him spread the ball around, get everybody involved is a thing of beauty.
So the first one drops, and that turns the lead to 6. Both free throws good from James.
Nice work there. This is a point in the game where if you've got a chance to close the gap, you've got to do it.
And Chalmers kicks to Bargnani. Out of bounds. Denver takes possession.
Where was he going with that pass? That's just an awful turnover.
Denver calls timeout. They're down by 5. 1:44 left here in the fourth quarter. Left in the game. Grant outside. Here's Blackman. Gets the 14-footer to fall. They got on this roll a while ago, and they just haven't looked back. And you can feel the crowd react as one.
Yeah, that guy got them out of their seats and off their hands.
Guys, they just exploded when it went down.
Minnesota calls timeout. They're up by 3. 1:27 left in the fourth quarter. Chalmers against James. Johnson double teamed. Here's Berry. That's in, coming off an assist from Johnson. 18 points for money.
Boy, even with the double teaming, he had the vision to find the open man.
Here's Red Hot. He feeds it to James. Tipped away. And so it looks like Denver will retain possession here. And 101 left in the fourth quarter. Clock at 6. Good! What a beautiful shot to Brown to within 3.
Well, his scoring this quarter has been off the charts. And the complexion of the game as a result may change.
And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
This
soft finger roll is just one of the many finishing moves he has in his bag of shot making. That free throw there caps off a huge possession for him. Those are big points at this stage of the game.
Let's it go. Let they get it back.
Nice job on the offensive line.
Boy, look at the rebound totals. He is absolutely dominating out there. Well, that's been something to watch. My goodness.
Out of bounds. Denver takes possession. Minnesota making a switch. Williams is checked in. Denver calls timeout. They're behind by six. There's 25 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Money's checked in for Minnesota. Here's Simmons.
Time running low here. They need a hoop.
Yeah, score quickly and then foul him right away.
Here's James. Excellent D there from Chalmers.
The defense was ready for him that time, and they had to be. He is so powerful in the lane.
First free throw is good, and that makes it a 7-point lead. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's an 8-point game. Williams with the ball. Number 6. Connects from downtown.
And I'm just impressed with his effort, guys, because we know he's hurting out there.
And an intentional foul right there. And he could not get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. Big group substitution now for Minnesota. Good, going 1 of 2 from the line, and that increases their lead to 6. 6 seconds left in the fourth. The 3 from Barnes. And so Minnesota takes the win. It was a solid win, Clark.
Yeah, it was, and I think it came down to will more than skill. They went out and got this one.